Subscribe to Simplified Biology channel and press the bell icon to get notified when a new video is uploaded. Hello friends, welcome to Simplified Biology. Today's topic is Human Circulatory System as requested. Human Circulatory System. Now before going to the Human Circulatory System, let's see the two different types of circulatory pathways. The two circulatory pathways are open circulatory system and closed circulatory system. Now in open circulatory system, the blood from the heart is pumped into an open space, that is the body cavity, also known as the hemocele. And they are also referred as the sinuses. Such type are seen in arthropods and in mollusks. Now in this pathway, the flow of fluid cannot be regulated. The second type is the closed circulatory system, where the blood from the heart is pumped or circulated through a closed network of blood vessels. As a result, the flow of fluid can be regulated. Closed circulatory system can be seen in annelids and in chordates. Now the muscular heart is present in all vertebrates. It is either two-chambered, three-chambered or four-chambered. Now two-chambered heart is found present in fishes, where the two chambers are the atrium and the ventricle. Now in fishes, single circulation is seen, that is the deoxygenated blood is pumped from the heart to the gills, where it gets oxygenated, and from there it is supplied to all parts of the body. In case of three-chambered heart, which is found in amphibians and reptiles, living crocodile, the heart has two atrium and a single ventricle. It has an incomplete double circulation. In this incomplete double circulation can be seen. Now in this, the left atrium receives oxygenated blood from the gills, lungs and skin, while the right atrium receives deoxygenated blood. It receives the deoxygenated blood from the other parts of the body. Blood from both the left and the right atrium are then passed through the vent to the ventricle, where it gets mixed, and then this mixed blood is from the ventricle is transferred to the other parts of the body. Now, the third type is the four-chambered heart, which is seen in crocodile, birds, and the mammals. Means the heart consists of two atrium and two ventricles. Now, in this, double circulation is seen. That is, the left atrium receives oxygenated blood, which passes it to the left ventricle, while the right atrium receives deoxygenated blood, which is passed to the right ventricle, and from there it is pumped out without mixing. The human circulatory system consists of a muscular heart that is chambered, having two auricles and two ventricles, and a network of blood vessels which are branched. A closed branching is seen, and third is the blood or the fluid that is transported through these blood vessels to the different parts of the body. Now, the human heart is mesodermal in origin. It is located in the thoracic cavity behind the sternum. In between the lungs. Now, this is the heart present in the thoracic cavity. It is conical in shape with the size of the fist. Now, this is the base of the heart and this is the apex. The apex is slightly tilted towards the left side. Now, the heart is protected by a double-walled membranous sac called the pericardium. The outer one of this is the double-layer membranous sac, that is the pericardium, the outer part of which is fibrous. In between the two walls lie a pericardial cavity, that is filled with pericardial fluid. Now, the pericardial fluid keeps the heart moist and prevents it from friction between the heart walls and the surrounding tissues. So, it keeps the heart wall moist and prevents friction between the heart wall and the tissue surrounding it. The four-chambered heart consists of two upper, smaller, and thinner atria that lie in the broader part of the heart, and two lower, larger, thicker ventricle that lie in the lower conical end of the heart. So, these are the two atrias, the right atrium and the left atrium, having a thin wall, and this is the right ventricle and the left ventricle having a thick wall protecting it. Now, the right atrium and the left atrium are separated from each other by interarterial septa. While the right ventricle is separated from the left ventricle with a thicker interventricular septa. In this diagram, the interarterial septa cannot be seen, but this is the interventricular septa, which is thicker, that separates the right ventricle from the left ventricle. Now, the atrium and the ventricle are separated from each other by atrioventricular septa. Now, this atrioventricular septa is made up of thick fibrous tissue. Now, the atrioventricular septa have openings in it by which they are connected with each other. Now, the right atrium is connected to the right ventricle with an opening called the tricuspid valve. As it has three flaps, it is referred as tricuspid valve. The left atrium is connected to the left ventricle by the bicuspid, also known as the mitral valve, as it has two flaps in it. The tricuspid and the bicuspid valve are directed towards the ventricles and they are attached to the wall of the ventricle by tendons called chordae tendinae. They prevent the blood that once reaches the ventricle to move back into the atrium. Similarly, the arteries that are connected to the ventricle, they too have a valves in it called the semilunar valves. Which allow one-way flow of blood. That is, the blood from the ventricle can move into the arteries and they cannot move back. Like the pulmonary semilunar valve guards the opening of the right ventricle, and similarly the aortic semilunar valve guards the opening of the left ventricle. Now, externally, grooves are present on the wall of the heart. A transfer groove is present between the atrium and the ventricle, which is known as the coronary sulcus. And also, grooves are present on the anterior and the posterior sides of the ventricle. They are known as anterior interventricular sulcus and posterior interventricular sulcus. Now, present in these grooves are the coronary arteries, which bring blood to the heart. Now, the right atrium receives deoxygenated blood while the left atrium receives oxygenated blood. Right atrium receives deoxygenated blood from all parts of the body, leaving the lungs through the superior vena cava. This is the superior vena cava and the inferior vena cava. While the left atrium receives oxygenated blood by the pulmonary veins from the lungs. The oxygenated blood reached the left atrium from the lungs. Now from the right ventricle, the blood reaches the lungs through the pulmonary artery. And from the left ventricle, the blood is transferred to all parts of the body. The oxygenated blood is transferred to all parts of the body through the aorta. Now the heart is a complex pumping organ. That receives blood from the different parts of the body into the atrium and pumps blood to the various parts of the body through the ventricle. The heart muscles or the cardiac muscles, they continuously generate impulse that is, they cause rhythmic contraction and relaxation. In which the atrial contracts first, followed by the ventricle. To maintain this heart rhythm, it has a highly specialized system. That consists of SA node, the internodal pathways, AV node, and Purkinje fibers. Now the nodal tissue, a specialized cardiac musculature, is distributed in the heart. A small mass of which, a small mass of the muscle fibers they are located at the right upper corner of the right atrium, forming the sinoatrial node, also known as the SAN node. This sinoatrial node is in direct contact with the atrial fibers. Another node is present at the low left corner of the right atrium called the atrioventricular node. Atrioventricular node or the AVN node, also known as the AVN node. It is present at the low left corner of the right atrium. Now from the AVN node develops a bundle of node fibers called the atrioventricular bundle. Now this atrioventricular bundle that develops from the AVN node passes through the interventricular septa, where it divides into two, the left bundle and the right bundle. This left and right bundle then develop branches which spread throughout the muscles of the ventricle, and they are referred as the Purkinje fibers. Developing from the AVN node are a bundle of fibers called the atrioventricular bundle, which divide into two. They form the left bundle and the right bundle. These left bundle and right bundle then produce minute fibers that spread throughout the muscles of the ventricle, and they are referred as the Purkinje fibers. The right bundle and the left bundle, along with the Purkinje fibers, are together referred as bundle of His. The right bundle and the left bundle, along with the Purkinje fibers, are together referred as bundle of His. Now, this nodal musculature of the heart is auto-excitable. Means it does not require any stimulus to generate its action potential. Which is responsible for the rhythmic movement of the heart. Now, the number of action potential generated in a minute vary at different parts of the nodal system. The SAN node generates the maximum action potential, and it is around 70 to 75 per minute. This action potential produced by the SAN node is responsible for the rhythmic contraction of the heart. And that is why the SAN node is also referred as the pacemaker. A normal heartbeat is 70 to 75 times per minute, with an average of about 72 beats per minute. That's all for today. Please do like, subscribe and comment, and also visit our website by clicking on the link given below. Thank you for watching.